Yes, hi everyone. Today's point of discussion is Dobereiner's law of triads. Dobereiner was German chemist. In 1800, about 30-31 elements were known. At that time, Dobereiner stated law of triads. Atomic masses of elements and properties of elements, they are related with each other. That relationship was stated, highlighted by the scientist Dobereiner. Okay, let's see which things are stated in the Dobereiner's law of triad and what is this Dobereiner's triad. Let's try to understand. In 1817, Dobereiner gave, in some book 1829 is also given, officially it was published. So in between 1817 to 1829, Dobereiner was working about the properties of elements and the atomic masses of the elements. So as to classify the elements, scientist Dobereiner firstly pointed out that atomic masses of elements should be considered. Okay, Dobereiner made a group of three elements with similar properties and called them as a triad. Okay, so the first Dobereiner's triad is which one? The first Dobereiner's triad is, that is nothing but the, let me write here, element and symbol. The first Dobereiner's triad, it consists of elements lithium alloy, sodium Na and potassium K. As you know, a group of three elements with similar properties, that is the triad. Then second group of three elements with similar properties, which Dobereiner noticed, that are nothing but the chlorine, Cl, bromine, Br, and iodine, I, chlorine, bromine, iodine. And the third Dobereiner's triad is which one? Calcium, Ca, strontium, Sr, calcium, strontium, and barium, Ba, calcium, strontium, barium. These three elements are there. Now what about their atomic mass of these elements? Atomic masses of these elements are, let me write here, 6.9 lithium, sodium 23, then potassium 39.1, chlorine 35.5, bromine 79.9, iodine 126, okay, 126.9, then calcium 40.1, then strontium 87.6, and barium 137.3. These are the atomic masses of the elements which are there in the three triads of the Dobereiner. Which interesting thing was noticed by the Dobereiner? Let me tell you that interesting thing. The interesting thing was that atomic mass of the middle element, okay, say for example, here in the first triad, which is the middle element, sodium, atomic mass of middle element is the average of atomic masses of, average of atomic masses of first and third element. Okay, so student, let's see what is the first element, what is the third element, and what is the average of atomic masses of first and third element. So first element 6.9, third element 39.1 divided by 2, so the average we are getting is 23. First element 35.5, third element is 126.9 divided by 2, so here we are getting the average 81.2. you may cross check. And first element calcium 40.1 plus third element barium 137.3 divided by 2, when we make the average of the atomic masses of first and last element, in the third case we are getting value 88.7. so this is the thing. Now let me tell you what is the exact statement of the law. According to the Dobereiner's law of triads, atomic mass of middle element is the average of atomic masses of first and last element. Okay, so middle element atomic mass 23, first element and last element its average is also 23. Okay, now here middle element's atomic mass, first and last. So that atomic mass, okay, now that whatever this law is stating, it is applicable, exactly applicable for the first triad. But for the second triad, what we are notifying? Atomic mass of middle element bromine 79.9 and first and last element atomic mass average is 81.2. It means that average of atomic mass of first and last element is equal to the middle element, that is approximately equal. Okay, now not exactly equal. And one more thing, instead of the word average, we can use the word arithmetic mean. Okay, and the third triad, atomic mass of middle element and average of the first and last element's atomic mass. Here it's 87.6 and average value is the 88.7. Okay, so this is about the Dobbs-Reiner's law of triad. Okay, that the relationship between the atomic masses of elements and elements with the similar properties, that was given by the Dobbs-Reiner. Okay, what are the limitations of this law? Many limitations we may state. The important limitation, main core limitation, is that this law is applicable for the few elements only. All elements can't be classified. Can we group all elements in the form of triads? No. Okay, now even at the time of Dobbs-Reiner also, a few such a group of elements, and nowadays also a few such a group of elements can be made. All elements, whatever the elements are known to us, all we can't classify in the form of triads. Okay, and based on that, we can say the limitation. For example, we have the elements like the carbon, nitrogen and oxygen. Their atomic masses are which one? Carbon 12, nitrogen 14 and oxygen 16. So in this case, atomic mass of middle element, that is 14, is equal to the average of atomic masses of the first and last element. Okay, now 28 by 2, that is the 14. So here this law is get followed mathematically, but these elements are not showing the similar properties. Okay, now so we may find group of elements in which they are following the law mathematically, but the law is such elements are not showing similar properties. Okay, now and we may take example of the transition elements or inner transition elements which are showing somehow similar properties. So in that, in such examples, such elements are not following the law mathematically. I hope you understood. This example, law is followed mathematically, but the chemical properties of these elements are not similar. We may take the examples of transition D block elements or F block element, inner transition elements, any three elements, and we may find that these are showing similar properties, but law is not get followed mathematically to them. Okay, today we will stop here. Bye. Yes.